There are several manufacturers of whole blood diluting systems used for manual white blood cell and platelet counts available. The system demonstrated in this video is the BMP Leukocheck system. It provides an easy method for the standardization of the pipetting and diluting of blood specimens. This system consists of a reservoir containing 1% buffered ammonium oxalate and a capillary pipette calibrated to deliver 20 microliters of sample. The reservoir contains a pre-measured volume of diluting fluid, 1.98 milliliters, and is sealed by a thin plastic diaphragm located in the neck of the reservoir. The pipette is self-filling and contains 20 microliters of fluid. The pipette shield is used to puncture the reservoir diaphragm just before use and to protect the pipette. Whole blood is added to the diluent, which lyses the erythrocytes while preserving leukocytes and platelets. When lysing is complete, the diluted blood is loaded into the hemacytometer for counting. Equipment needed for this procedure includes BMP reservoir with a 20 microliter pipette, hemacytometer with cover glass, lint-free tissues, and a timer. The specimen used in this procedure is whole blood, either free-flowing capillary blood or thoroughly mixed anticoagulated venous blood. EDTA is the anticoagulant of choice as it preserves white blood cell morphology. Remove the pipette from the shield. To dilute the specimen for analysis, the reservoir is placed on a flat surface. While grasping the reservoir with one hand, take the pipette assembly in the other hand and push the pointed end of the pipette shield firmly through the reservoir diaphragm, as far as possible into the reservoir to ensure an opening large enough through which the pipette fits. Then remove the shield from the reservoir. Make sure to mix the specimen well before filling the pipette with the specimen. Holding the pipette horizontally, touch the tip of the pipette to the blood specimen and allow it to fill. This occurs automatically through capillary action. When the blood reaches the neck of the pipette, no more blood will enter. Carefully wipe excess blood from the outside of the pipette using a lint-free tissue. Be careful not to touch the end of the pipette, as the tissue may draw some sample from the pipette and negatively impact your dilution and thus your cell count. Place your index finger over the top of the overflow chamber. Gently squeeze the reservoir with the other hand. While maintaining this pressure, insert the filled pipette into the neck of the reservoir and seat it firmly in place. It is important to cleanly insert the pipette into the reservoir and not lose any blood in the process. Release the pressure on the reservoir and remove your finger from the overflow chamber simultaneously. Negative pressure will draw the blood from the pipette into the diluent reservoir. Gently squeeze and release the reservoir again to rinse the pipette 2 or 3 times to make sure the pipette is adequately rinsed. Be careful not to allow fluid to overflow the reservoir when it's squeezed, as this will affect the count. If this occurs during the first squeezing of the reservoir, the dilution steps may need to be repeated. Gently mix the reservoir several times to thoroughly combine the blood and diluent, and allow it to incubate for 10 minutes at room temperature to ensure adequate lysing of red blood cells. After 10 minutes have elapsed, follow the instructions for loading the hemacytometer for counting.